Hello, folks. Dr. Charles Parker here from New ADHD Medication Rules, and I'm going to tell you something, and if it wasn't happening to you, it would be really funny, okay? But if it's been you suffering for 10, 20, 30 years with medication failures, I can tell you right now, it is not funny at all. So we're going to have a little humor together here where I'm going over this with you. And any of you who've heard me do presentations like at the national meeting of the ADHD Coaches Organization, you'll know that we've had some laughs on this, but they're really uncomfortable laughs because the gastrointestinal tract, the mouth to the south, makes a big difference. And if that gastrointestinal tract is not moving correctly, then what's going to happen? The metabolism of the medication is going to be altered. And it's going to be altered in a very profoundly negative way. So what can happen, to use another street metaphor, we're talking about the mouth of the south, now I'm going to talk about chasing your tail. What can happen? You and your doctor can be chasing your tail out in the yard like a dog in a yard, trying to figure out what to do over years of messing with medication, when this essential point is neglected or considered, but then overlooked. The transit time from the mouth to the south can actually corrupt the way your liver works. There are plenty of studies on this. I mean, some people will say, well, I've had my liver tested and my liver is totally fine. I mean, all my liver profile, my doctor thought about that and he looked at my liver and my liver tests are really negative. I don't have a problem there. Well, how your liver is tested and whether it's normal or not really has not a whole lot to do with the rate of metabolism of your liver, secondary to the fact that it's a secondary sewage treatment plant backing up what's going on with your bowel. So if your bowel is not working right, and the mouth to the south is either going too fast or too slow, then you're going to have a problem because that liver is constantly playing catch-up ball for what the bowel isn't doing correctly. You're going to have a relatively malnourished condition. Doesn't matter whether you're overweight or underweight, you're very likely going to be, with that whole mouth to the south transit time being corrupted, you're actually going to be malabsorbing your medications and malabsorbing your food. And your liver, which is the main pathway, we've talked about 2D6, we've talked about the variety of things the liver has to do to actually metabolize amphetamine and methylphenidate products. Well, what happens is they get metabolized, but if the liver is slowed down in some way, they don't get metabolized. And you can either have an inadequacy in terms of your ability to metabolize the medication, or it can just run through extremely quickly. And you can, it looks like it's running through, you can actually accumulate it and you can actually be overdosed on very small amounts. And there are two things that happen, and I'll tell you more about them in another video. One is the narrow therapeutic window in which a little bit doesn't do it, and just a little bit more is, whoa, too much, and you're coming out the top of the window. Down here, you're in the bottom, and now you're coming out the top. That's the narrow therapeutic window. Or the roving therapeutic window, wherein you get the medication right, the person's in the window, and then slowly but surely they come out the bottom of the window, and by golly, it's not working right again. Or over time, oh my gosh, I'm on too much. That's all GI related. Mouth to the south, the rate makes a difference. Look down below right here, and I'm going to have a transit time PDF download for you. You can take a look at it. Have a few laughs. Discuss it. Do the corn test, actually measure your transit time, and I'll tell you more about it in another video, but I'm going to stop now. Thanks for paying attention. Have a great day.